At the bronze foundry, a mold is made of the object which is to be cast. Hot beeswax is poured and a thin layer allowed to form on the inner surface of the mold. The mold is removed, leaving a hollow reproduction of the original model in wax. Plaster is poured into the hollow to form a core. On the outside surface of the wax, layers of plaster, called an investment, are built up, sandwiching the wax between an inner core and these outer investments. A brick and clay oven is then constructed around the investment. During the baking, the wax runs out through specially prepared channels called vents. When the wax runs out, it leaves a space between the core and investment into which the bronze will be poured. Hardwood is still used because it heats the oven slowly. As the temperature rises, the plaster dries before the wax begins to run. After the baking, the oven is broken down and the investments are packed in sand contained by an iron frame. The sand prevents the molten metal from escaping through the vents.
Anyway, in the art foundry, we cannot arrange our equipment as in a commercial foundry, because we must hand the metal as we want. We can pick off the metal from the oven, and we have no pyrometer to judge the temperature. It is our experience which judges the right temperature, because I must consider how the metal must be hot, more or less in proportion to the figure which I must cast. When we pour the metal, we must be there, because we must go in a hurry or slowly according to the shape of the figure. Therefore, we are working with the metal almost in our hand.
Bronze, an alloy of copper, tin, and lead, is poured through a gate in the base of the investment. It fills the space left by the wax and runs out the vents until it is stopped by the sand. After the bronze has cooled, the investments are broken open and the metal that remained in the gate and vents is clipped off and filed down. The surface of the bronze is then checked for flaws in the casting, chased and finished.
Well, is the birthplace of the antique metallurgy.